Calendar is the best way to manage events. Along the center of the toolbar, we have four views. We'll begin with the month view. To create an event, double-click in the middle of a date. We'll be prompted to name the event. Now I can add as much information about this event as I'd like, beginning with location. Once typing in a location, I'm provided with suggestions. My suggestion could be as broad or as general as a building, or as specific as an address. In this example, we're using the Ferry Building. Calendar integrates with maps. Near the bottom, I can now see my destination, along with the weather for that day and time. To specify the time, I click here. I can choose whether it's an all-day event with no specific time, or I can say this event begins at noon to 2 o'clock. I can also manually type a time. If this is a repeating event, I can tell the computer whether it's daily, weekly, monthly, or annually. I can even customize a specific repetition. For example, on the first Wednesday of each month, regardless of the date. Calendar can factor in travel time. Once more, as it integrates with maps, it can estimate to me driving and walking times, depending on the time of day and traffic. Or I can manually choose a duration. I can choose an alert of when to be reminded of this event. Placing my cursor to the right side of an alert, this plus button allows me to create as many alerts as I'd like. Clicking Add Invitees will integrate my calendar with my contacts. If I choose to invite someone, they'll receive an invitation through email. Any additional information can be provided by clicking Add Notes, Attachments, or URL. Clicking anywhere else in my calendar will close that dialog. If I wish to customize my event, I can double-click on it and make any change as necessary. Changing a date of an event is as simple as clicking and dragging it to the day I wish it to be on. The week view may be a more efficient way of creating events. Each notch within a day represents an hour and a half hour point. Positioning my cursor, clicking and dragging, I can create an event. Once I let go, I have the same dialog window to provide as much information as I'd like about this event. It may also be easier to reschedule events within the week view. Click and drag in either direction to change the time of the event, or the day, or positioning the cursor on either the top or bottom edges, I can extend or contract the duration of this event. Click and create as many events as you'd like. The day view expands upon this concept. Along the left side, I have a list. I can scroll up or down and view any of my upcoming events within a linear list view. On the right side is an expansion of that particular day. The year view is a quick way to jump to a specific day or time within a year. Let's go back to the month view. The left side of the toolbar is a calendars tool. Clicking that allows me to see the sidebar. Your calendar can synchronize across many different internet services. Most recommended is iCloud. You can color coordinate different schedules within your life using multiple different calendars. Once creating an event, I can click the color box to the right, and this allows me to choose which calendar this event belongs to. This is useful because now I can uncheck a box next to a calendar I don't wish to see. Create a new calendar through the File menu, New Calendar, and choose which internet account you want that calendar to be created within. Calendar colors can be customized. When selecting a calendar, visit the Edit menu, Get Info. This is one easy way to rename a calendar, provide a description of it, or change the color. Within the sidebar, we have subscribed holidays and birthdays. Calendars which have been subscribed to cannot be changed within the calendar application itself. Birthdays, for instance, are entered in within the contacts application. As calendars integrated with contacts, it automatically makes those birthdays available and visible. They are represented with a little gift icon. It is possible to collaborate or share your calendar with others. When selecting the calendar you wish to share, press the Publish icon to the right. Names or emails are integrated with contacts, and the recipient receives an email with an invitation to view your calendar events. The plus button on the left side of the toolbar is another quick way to create an event. The example demonstrates you begin with a subject, then a time, then a day. Along the right side of the toolbar is our Spotlight search. As with every other Mavericks application, typing in your term will provide that result, if it exists within the calendar.